head in the clouds? It's easy. If you're driving through the Great Smoky Mountains of Tennessee, 50 to 60 inches of rain fall here every year. But finding a cloud for your head here in the desert of the Southwest is difficult. Only 3 to 5 inches of rainfall per year. Day after day of hot sun and temperatures over 100 degrees make the desert a tough environment for plants and present a challenge for landscape architects. Landscape architects develop designs for the outside of homes and buildings. They use plants to make a structure more attractive, but plants can also provide a home for animals and protection from the sun and wind. Melody Cavaneri is a resource specialist in the desert Southwest who works with people to develop landscape plans that make sense for a desert environment.
Because water is so scarce, it's important for the desert's human inhabitants to conserve whenever possible.
The term xeriscape derives from the Greek word xeris, which means dry.
In desert areas, it's appropriate to use native or drought-tolerant landscaping materials whenever possible. If you use materials that come from areas where there is a great deal of rainfall, they require a considerable amount of water. Lawns are a good example of this. They need to be watered almost year-round, and not only do they use a lot of water in terms of what they actually take up through their root system, but a lot of water is lost through evaporation to the air. A lot of trees need to be deep watered that aren't indigenous to the desert regions. Lots of perennials need to be coaxed along and require lots of water and a lot of effort on the part of the homeowner or landscaper. So the bottom line is that if you choose a drought-tolerant plant species, you'll use much less water, you'll have to expend much less energy, you'll get an equally appropriate and satisfying landscaping effect, and you'll also be conserving water. You'll be in tune with the desert environment.